I feel the master. I feel the master. Y'all ready? They ready? Well, come on. Come on. Ready. Y'all ready? They ready?
We ready.
We ready. We ready.
Oh, yeah.
You know, this program has meant the world to me ever since I was a little kid, coming to Catholic Central football games, seeing the players, imagining that being me one day, and just coming back to state championship a third time with my brothers means the world to me.
Let's go, man. Firework, one out, three, one, two, three.
The biggest impact this program has had on me is understanding how far hard work can take you.
The most important thing I'm going to take away from this program is discipline, how to evaluate myself, look myself in the mirror, and know that only I can cut myself short.
The most important thing this program has taught me is just to have a determined mindset in everything that I do, whether that's football, whether that's school, whether that's life, relationships, anything like that.
The program kind of showed you what it's like to put so much into something and then get everything back in return.
I think we've definitely matured over the years. We've just come a long way, and it's really cool to see everyone grow.
Seeing the work like progress through the season as you like keep going. You see other teams, you know, like they struggle to keep up, their seasons are done, but then you really see the hard work.
It's amazing because of all the time and commitment it takes, and the relationships with these guys, I know, will last a long time.
The coaching staff and all these players, when we come together, there's nothing like Catholic Central football.
All the people around me, they're going to push me to be the best that I could possibly be, no matter the situation, whether it's inside football, outside of football, anything.
You know you can trust the man next to you.
The people that I hang out with on the weekends, outside of football, outside of the season, are the exact same people that are on this football team, and I'm probably going to have these friendships for the rest of my life.
We work hard in the weight room and the field, and this is our goal in mind we've always had, and we've done it.
Being on this team, it's a big commitment, but it's worth it. And every day we are out there and we practice for each other, we play for each other.
Best 4 years of my life. I love these guys, every single kid on this team.
I've known these guys since I was in middle school, so it's like the bonds we have with them are tighter than anyone else knows.
Just these guys are my favorite, you know, like these are my best friends.
Nothing compares to this. You know, nothing compares to, you know, running out and stuff with all these teammates and putting all the hard work and stuff. That just makes you a little closer.
Everyone here just works way harder than everyone else. I think that's why we're successful. And Coach Colster does a great job of getting everyone prepared.
For anything to work in the sport of football, you gotta have teamwork. A lot of our teamwork and our chemistry comes from our practices, because we really bust our butt in practice to make sure that we'll get it done in the game.
We're willing to put in time that not a lot of other people are willing to do. And we have fun while we're doing it too.
We definitely know when it's time to work, and we like to work hard, come together, because we know at the end of the day, nobody can stop us except ourselves.
You really learn to like adapt a way of hard work and mental toughness and just outworking your opponents. I mean, we work harder than everybody in the state, and that's what you really learn.
We know what it's like at the top of the mountain, so we'll do anything it takes to get back there. I think that's what we keep in the back of our heads the whole season.
Our motivation to work hard is the team around us and knowing that putting in the work will lead to a greater outcome than if we were to take the easy road.
Work ethic is definitely something that we've built our team on. It's something we preach every day, just working our hardest.
I mean, we're going to our third state championship, and just, I know how much work it is. Not many people know, and I know I just have to continue that work ethic to be great.
If you work hard, you'll get rewarded in the end. It's a lot to get to where we're at right now. There's most teams that don't really even like sniff the playoffs, and we've gone to state championship as our third year in a row.
Outwork, out-prepare, and finish. I mean, that's what we're taught right when we come in here. It's just outwork, out-prepare, and finish, and that's our mindset going through everything.
I'm just proud that, you know, we're coming back for the third time in a row. That's pretty hard.
So whenever I'm in a tough situation in life, I'll think, man, I made it through 4 years of summer workouts. I can make it through anything. I made it through 2-a-days. I can do anything.
Saturday, we're going to the state championship.
It's crazy going 13-0, going for a championship. I've never been in this position.
I'm just glad to see what it's really like to go to Ford Field.
I'm confident in our guys. I'm confident that we're going to get it done.
This is fun, actually going out there and playing a real football game.
Nobody prepares like we do in the entire state.
This Saturday, we're going to bring home a championship trophy.
Saturday, we're going to go back to the crib for the third year in a row. We're going to play a heck of a football game and hopefully get another ring.
And let us not grow weary of doing good, for in the due season we will reap if we do not give up. For you have need of endurance, so that when you have done the will of God, you may receive what is promised. But the one who endures to the end will be victorious.
Well, I think the first quarter, you know, we had the opening drive, we went all the way down. When we got down to the red zone, we missed a couple things and just, okay, let's relax, let's bang the field goal through.
Snap is a good one, hold is down, kick is up, and he drilled it right through the uprights, no doubt about it. Meyer, a good kicker.
You know, our defense goes out there, plays well, create a turnover.
So the Cougars get the first turnover of the game.
And, you know, we end up scoring.
Bellinger right side, fighting towards the goal line, touchdown! Catholic Central from 3 yards out.
They hit us on one big play.
Heslop wants to throw, complete, and up the sideline. Still on his feet inside the 40, 35, 30. Tetler.
And then, you know, we take him down to fourth down and a yard. It's a matter of inches, so they get the first down by inches, like maybe 2 inches at most. Or they ended up scoring and making it 10-7, so it was a tighter game and so on. And then at halftime, I think their guys were... they were struggling, you know, and our guys, I think, felt fine. Coming out in the third quarter, we felt like we had some good options to run the ball. It gave us some opportunities to look at some different things on offense that, you know, we got going with.
He's down the sideline, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Nolan Ziegler.
Fourth quarter comes, and it's clear we're wearing them out, and they're on offense. It was almost like they just kind of threw their hands up almost, like saying, hey, like we can't, there's nothing we can do here. And then obviously we took advantage of that and went down and scored. And again, and had some nice plays and had a good drive. And then defensively got a stop again and got the turnover. And, you know, and then that's it. Just to see our guys defensively get that, because I think they definitely deserved it. Jack Claffett, our Mike linebacker, coming around the horn on that and being able to scoop and score. And so it was just, to me, it was like the epitome of our defense, really. Everybody doing their job, and when the ball's down, we're going to get it, and let's go take it the other way. And Jack was able to do that. So it was just a really good way to end it.